Hey guys, it's Shonda Hunt here with the first episode of my post series, Chapter 1, Episode 1. Chapter 1 will focus on Nuke's user interface, and I will break the chapter down into smaller episodes that will focus on each individual pane and panel in Nuke. Depending on which version of Nuke you are using, your panes and tools will be laid out differently. In this episode, I am using Nuke 13.2 V2. When you first open Nuke, you'll see several panes: the Viewer pane, the Properties pane, and here we have the Node Graph, the Curve Editor, and the Dope Sheet. In the upper hand corner of each of these panes, we see a little box which controls how we view the pane, and it gives us a drop-down list of options. If we choose any, but we want to go back to our original setup, we can simply go to Workspace, Reset Workspace, and that will bring us back to where we started. In this episode, I will focus on the Viewer pane and several of the tools for this pane. The Viewer pane will display whatever source you have connected to your viewer node from the node graph. When you start a new project, the Viewer pane will be black. That is because we haven't brought anything in to view through the viewer node. What you can see is the bounding box as well as the resolution. This is the default resolution of our project. It will change once we import footage. However, it will not change in the project settings unless we change it manually. I did open the project settings using the keyboard shortcut. However, in this episode, I want to focus on the viewer pane and the viewer node. By default, when you open Nuke, a viewer node is created for us. If we want to create a new viewer node ourselves, there are several ways to do this. You can go to Viewer and select New Comp Viewer. It also shows us the keyboard shortcut, Control-I. So we can drop that in, and now we have two viewers. So we have Viewer 1 and Viewer 2. Another way to create a viewer node is to right-click inside of our node graph, select Image, and select Viewer. And now we have another viewer. There's another way to simply press the tab key. You'll get a pop-up, and viewer is usually the first one, but you can also type it in. And you can create another viewer that way. And of course, the last way which we saw was to hit Control-I in our node graph, and that will also create a viewer for us. This example of creating viewers in several different ways is an example of just how flexible Nuke is. There are usually several ways to do the exact same task, and this allows each individual user to create a workflow that they are comfortable with. Now that we have the viewer node, we will import some footage so that we can go over some tools for the viewer pane. We import footage through a process also called bringing in a read node, and the read node will display your footage. Of course, there are several ways to bring in a read node in Nuke. We can simply hover our mouse inside the node graph and press the R key. It will load a pop-up which we can browse to find our footage. We can also click the image icon and select read. The pop-up will appear once again. In the node graph, we can right-click, click image, and select read. And lastly, we can press tab And we can type in read. And the pop-up will appear once again. Let's connect one of our read nodes to the viewer. Now we have an image in the viewer node and in the viewer window. This first dropdown that we have here is the layer dropdown. It controls what channels are mapped to the RGB in the viewer pane. By default, it's set to RGBA. However, there is a drop-down menu, and you can change it to whichever channel you want to map to the RGBA. Here, I imported a CG render so that we could see that there are other channels that we can view. If we were viewing live action footage, normally we would only have 3 channels. Since we do have another read node, all the channels are still loading, but in this image, we only have the red, green, and blue channels. These color codes let us know which channels are available in our read node. Let's go back to our CG render so we can cycle through some of the channels. So although we are viewing these channels, we're still viewing them in the RGB color space. The viewer will always display images in the RGB space unless you are viewing the alpha channel. To view the alpha channel, we can press A on the keyboard, or we can change it to alpha here using the channel selector. Most digital device displays are based on some type of RGB color model because RGB is the most efficient way to represent most of the colors that humans can see. We will get into Nuke's color management system later, of course, but for now, I want you to understand why we are viewing the RGB color combination. The next dropdown, which controls which channels are mapped to the alpha channel in the viewer. And the last dropdown is the channel selector, which allows us to choose which channels we want to view. We can view each channel individually by simply clicking on red, green, or blue. We can also view the luminance, and we can also view the matte overlay. The matte overlay will appear red. Now I know that pressing M while my mouse is in the viewer pane will turn on the matte overlay, which will place the alpha over the RGB channel. Before I get into some of the keyboard shortcuts for the viewer pane, I do want to talk a little bit more about how we can remap channels using these tools. So I'll stick with our CG image since it has more channels. Let's say, for instance, I want to view the alpha channel. And this is the alpha channel that came in with my EXR node. If I want to remap another channel to be displayed in my viewer in the alpha channel, I could select it from this dropdown. So now I've remapped my red channel to be displayed in the alpha channel. And I could do the same with all of the channels that I have. Now, some of the keyboard shortcuts for the viewer pane. If I want to view my red, I can press R while my mouse is in the viewer pane. And I will get the red channel. You can see it changing here. G and B. If you press B again, it will go back to the RGB. If you press G twice, it will switch between the green channel and the RGB. This works for any channel. If you double click the keyboard shortcut. So you press it once and it will switch the channel. You press it again and it will go back to the RGB. Let's continue with the input process button. Currently, the input process button is grayed out, and that is because the input process button only appears if there's an input process set in the viewer settings that will be driven by a node from the node graph. Nuke will use whatever node is selected as the input process to process the image that is displayed in the viewer. I do want to note, when you are working, your input process will be driven by a color space node, and that usually comes for whatever show or project you're working on. It will usually come in when you build the script for your project. However, it can also be set manually. You can create an input process by creating a node in the node graph. So I'll just create a grade node here. Now this grade node will have to be named whatever the input process is set for in the viewer settings. So to bring up the viewer settings, I'll click on the viewer, and while my mouse is in the viewer pane, I'll click S. We already have the settings that showed up here. Right here, the input process is looking for a node called viewer input. So if I copy that, and I take my grade node, and I simply change the name to viewer input, I want you to watch what happens here. Now the input process button is activated. So this grade node, we set this grade node to guide our input process here. So while the button's activated, I'll go ahead and make some changes to this grade node, and you'll see that those changes are now being displayed in the viewer, although this grade node is not connected to anything. It's not connected to any read notes. It's not connected to the viewer, which normally you would have to have the grade node connected to the viewer to see any changes. But since we set that grade node as our input process, we can simply see the changes in the viewer now. And the difference is the changes that we make to this grade node to view our image differently here will not affect our final image or our rendered output. This is simply to adjust how we're seeing our image in the viewer pane. Now, I do want to take a moment to note that when you're using keyboard shortcuts in Nuke, it is important to make sure your mouse is inside of the correct panel. If you're working and you accidentally press a key on your keyboard while your mouse is in the wrong pane, you may get stuck wondering why things didn't change or why you aren't seeing what you were trying to see. And that's because you pressed the keyboard shortcut while inside of the wrong pane. If I click the S key on my keyboard while my mouse is here in the node graph, the project settings will appear here in the properties panel. If I click S while my mouse is here in the viewer pane, I get the settings for the viewer. So it's important to make sure your mouse is in the correct window when you're using keyboard shortcuts. The last tool that we will cover in this episode from the viewer is the viewer process dropdown. By default, sRGB is selected when you create a new comp. And that's because it is the best guess default for a computer monitor. There are some predefined viewer processes which appear in this dropdown, but you can also build your own. When a process viewer is selected from the viewer process dropdown, any image that you view in your viewer window will be passed through that process. Both the input process and viewer process are tools to modify your image in the viewer window before it is displayed on your monitor. These changes will not affect your rendered output. They will only affect what's being displayed in the viewer. The last note that I do want to go over is the layer contact sheet. So if you press tab and type out layer contact sheet, and again, I can click on this note and press any number key on my keyboard, and that will create a new viewer input for me. So I already have 1 and 2, so I'll just select 3. You don't have to go in order though. You can select 6, 7, 8. You can select any number you want. But I just want to show you this note because it's a pretty cool way to see all of the layers that come in with your read node at once. So in this one read node, that's a CG render output, you have all of these channels and you can see them all at once. This is a good way for checking to make sure you have all the channels you need and to make sure that everything was rendered out properly from the CG department. That's all we're going to cover in this episode. However, we will be back in the next episode to continue going over the rest of the tools for the viewer.